Here's a quick fact. More information has been generated in the past 10 years than in the entire rest of human history combined. Give that a moment to sink in. How does it make you feel? For most, this reality is too overwhelming, if not frightening, to truly metabolize. Instead, the majority will grasp at whatever shreds of certainty they can find, clinging to the models of the past and closing their minds to the new demands of the future. Unfortunately, we'll no longer be able to get away with sticking our heads in the sand. Not if we wish to survive disruption after disruption, let alone thrive alongside them. We all feel it, change is accelerating, with uncertainty and threat of disruption in every segment. Artificial intelligence, automation, programmable biology, robotics, and other technologies are transforming existing industries and spawning new ones. In this volatile and fluid environment, established approaches to strategy development no longer work. There is no stable industry structure or new market equilibrium that we will return to when change abates. Drawing on decades of research and case studies from both businesses and nonprofits, Robert McLean and Charles Conn have identified 6 strategic mindsets that give companies and individuals a critical strategic advantage in ambiguous and uncertain circumstances: curiosity, dragonfly eye perspective, experimentalism, collective intelligence, storytelling, and imperfectionism, the overarching mindset. In this summary, you'll learn what characterizes each mindset and how you can start to develop all 6 in your own career and life. Our world's rapid evolution is here to stay. If you want to stay ahead of the curve, now's the time to double down on your creative problem-solving skills. Chapter 1 Strategic Mindset 1 Curiosity in the 1970s, Minnesota mining and manufacturing made a pioneering change. While the rest of manufacturing America was intent on continuing assembly line productivity, 3M required employees to spend up to 15% of their paid hours away from core tasks. Why? Well, they wanted to imbue their organization with a spirit of curiosity. If people had time to pursue their interests, they figured, the result would be more innovation. Many similar companies have risen and fallen since then. Meanwhile, 3M has been in operation for over a century. Curiosity is at the heart of innovation. Just take the Nespresso capsule, which was invented by a brilliant engineer named Eric Fevre. Fevre was curious about why there was a longer line at a particular coffee shop in Rome, St. Eustatios. He investigated and discovered how they created a remarkable crema on their espresso, which he later reproduced in the lab. Psychologists define curiosity as the desire to bridge the gap between our current knowledge and what we'd like to know. For McLean and Conn, it's the most foundational strategic mindset. As much as we may rail against uncertainty, curiosity can't exist without it. We're innately inquisitive beings. From the moment we're born until about the age of 5, our curiosity compounds. Case in point, researchers have found some toddlers ask 300 questions per day. Researchers have also identified a curiosity sweet spot, where the level of uncertainty is neither too over nor underwhelming. At this midpoint, we can tackle complex creative problems with relative confidence of success. So why have studies found that only 24% of us experience curiosity at work? While certain deadlines and metrics need to be met, do we have to sacrifice questioning and experimentation to do so? Examples like 3M and Google show us the two aren't mutually exclusive. What might adoption look like in practice? There are 3 ways in. The first is putting yourself in the path of stimulating people, places, and conversations. The second is not feeling afraid to pose rudimentary or absurd questions. Ask why to everything without fear. And the third is cultivating conditions for novelty, gestation, and safety in your workplace to make creative thinking welcome, just as Nespresso did when it gave Eric Fevre time and space to be curious about the espresso crema. The coming years will be bumpy for those who stick hard and fast to assumptions and the status quo. That's the way we've always done it will become less a point of pride and more a cause for serious concern. by making small shifts in your life today, such as engineering an interaction with someone in another department, for example, or going for a walk during your lunch break to let your thinking percolate, you'll be well on your way to cultivating the first strategic mindset our near future demands. Chapter 2 Strategic Mindset 2 Dragonfly Eye Perspective. The dragonfly is one of nature's most exquisite creations. With two 30,000 lens compound eyes and another three with a simple lens, these insects can see 360 degrees with unparalleled vividness. McLean and Conn borrowed the term dragonfly eye to describe the second strategic mindset, alluding to the similarly multi-perspective approach our future's creative problems will require. With the number of disruptors growing, those who continue to operate with a single lens will find themselves relentlessly blindsided. There are three ways to start exercising this mindset in your career and life. First, come at problems from a few different angles. Invisalign is an orthodontic solution with a current market cap of over $15 billion. Yet many are surprised to discover that its creators, Kelsey Wirth and Zia Chishti, were MBA students, not orthodontists, when they struck upon the idea. Despite having no expertise in dentistry, they were able to see an improvement on braces that incumbents couldn't, shaking up the industry in the process. The trick was to shift perspectives and reimagine braces from the perspective of the wearer. Second, zoom in and out of problems to get a picture at both the micro and macro levels. An example of playing with a problem's aperture is the HIV crisis that swept India in the early 2000s. When public health consultant Ashok Alexander took on this issue, all he could see was the overwhelming tangle of contributing factors. It wasn't until he zoomed way in and examined a single thread, the social dynamic of female sex workers, that a solution started to reveal itself: negotiation with clients. Pulling at this thread further, his Gates Foundation-funded Avahan program prevented approximately 600,000 cases of infection. Finally, use the insights gleaned from these multiple perspectives to inform your strategy. Investing in multi-perspective exercises doesn't then give you a hall pass for going with the single-lens approach you always intended. The investment should inspire a real-world solution. While single-lens strategies won't become obsolete, we'd be wise to shift toward the dragonfly eye sooner rather than later. Uncertain times will inevitably bring unforeseeable events, but adopting multiple perspectives will ensure we significantly reduce the number of preventable blind spots. Chapter 3 Strategic Mindset 3 Experimentalism or Occurrent Behavior. Fly, test, fail, fix. This is the mantra of pioneering space exploration company, SpaceX. Personal opinions of Elon Musk aside, it's hard not to admire his bold approach to innovation in the almost incomparably high-cost, high-risk arena of interstellar travel. With this bold experimentalist approach, the company has driven down the cost of lifting a kilogram into space by 95%. SpaceX epitomizes McLean and Conn's third strategic mindset. Musk and his team use real-world observations rather than dated expectations to inform their strategy. In other words, they prize occurrent behavior over hypotheses. This stance may sound like a no-brainer, but it's surprisingly easy to get led astray. After all, it's easier, cheaper, and often more comforting, at least in the short term, to run with old data than a whole new experiment. But remember that we're living in a world of unprecedented information generation. Existing models and datasets are quickly outmoded. So, in addition to experimenting more frequently, we can pull two other levers to approach problems with a true fly, test, fail, fix mindset: novel data analytics and natural experiments. As with existing datasets, existing data capture and analysis tools are unlikely to continue providing the greatest return on investment. An interesting example of breaking through here is the Chinese Uber competitor, Didi, whose AI-driven planning systems use weather and traffic light data to optimize driver numbers and locations. It's also worth watching out for natural experiments, unintentional yet serendipitous exercises led by Mother Nature herself, to see whether we can sidestep the heavy lifting altogether. Natural experiments can offer our organizations tremendous value at minimal cost. For instance, are there twin cities with different policies we can learn from? Or twin siblings with different upbringings we can examine for medical insight? Or could we compare different countries' COVID policy outcomes and use those to develop future pandemic strategies? It's true that there's a cost to frequent experimentation and analytic tool development. However, in the coming years, there'll be a far greater cost in not experimenting and developing at all. Chapter 4 Strategic Mindset 4 Collective intelligence experts will cease to offer the value they've historically provided. It's a controversial claim that brings the author's previous consultant livelihoods into question, but it's one they stand by nonetheless. Once upon a time, individuals and organizations would call in industry experts for highly specific solutions or support. The old hands they were, experts could quickly and relatively reliably deliver based on their extensive previous experience. Today, the landscape looks very different. New technologies arrive at an exponential rate, new players enter and exit every day, and new rules or new business models arise to disrupt the previous incumbents with regularity. Old success patterns peddled by experts won't work. One way for companies or organizations to tap into genuinely novel ideas to solve creative problems is to look to collective intelligence. Collective intelligence can be thought of as collaboration 2.0. It's the strategic use of a group of diverse individuals from outside your organization on highly uncertain, highly complex creative problems. McLean and Conn have identified three flavors of collective intelligence. The first is crowdsourced expertise, the second is collective wisdom, and the third is human-AI collaboration. With the recent arrival of AI like ChatGPT, we can all no doubt picture what the first of these might look like in practice. A great example would be the Nature Conservancy, an environmental organization, utilizing a Kaggle competition to crowdsource fish recognition AI to reduce bycatch of endangered tuna species by the international fishing fleet. This is a brilliant new tool brought to conservation from outside. The second idea is to access older wisdom that, with a little research and humility, could be harnessed without needing to reinvent the wheel. Fire management in Northern Australia, for instance, saw explosive advancement when it turned to the local indigenous communities for advice. Today, this combined model of ancient wisdom and cutting-edge science successfully manages a particularly high-risk grassland area of over 120 million hectares. The third idea is harnessing the interaction of humans and artificial intelligence. For example, AI swarms, the interaction of human forecasters and competing AI models is leading to better prediction of sporting outcomes and even early diagnosis of cancer. As we move forward, experts will still contribute unique insights, and we should graciously hear out their recommendations. But it will no longer prove wise to have all our eggs in the expert basket. On this new frontier, the sum really will be greater than its parts. Chapter 5 Strategic Mindset 5 Storytelling. Do you remember show and tell from your early school days? Whether you loved or resented being called on, most of us enjoyed sitting in the audience. It was refreshing to see knowledge and entertainment go hand in hand. McLean and Conn's fifth strategic mindset, storytelling, is more meta than standalone. Think of it as the mindset that amplifies all the mindsets before it. Data can be compelling. But the point of solving complex problems is to solve a complex problem. It's to improve the world in some small way, not to try to impress people with facts and figures. As the bombardment of data accelerates, it'll be the insights wrapped in engaging narratives that will ultimately cut through. Fortunately, you don't need to be a trained thespian to reap the storytelling mindset's advantages. Instead, try using one of four tools when you next need to make your case. The first is striking imagery, also known as the killer graphic. Traditional black and white text and tables have their place, but if your data can be displayed as a boldly colored, easy-to-absorb mind map, go for it. Similarly, don't be afraid to rope in a prop or two. A lecture on the annual food waste of average households might spark awareness, for example, but imagine the impact of representing these amounts in full trash cans beside you while you talk. Demonstrations can be equally powerful, especially when the other party may need some convincing. For instance, it isn't uncommon for companies to hire hackers to test their cybersecurity. Exposed vulnerabilities are hard to refute. In one example cited by the authors, a team actually set up and half-executed a bank robbery at a Federal Reserve Bank. Finally, strive to speak to people's hearts just as much as their heads. We all know logic alone isn't enough to inspire action. If it were, cigarettes and climate change would pose far less of a problem than they do. Tie your reasoning to people's values. Add a touch of emotion to your logic. Frame your findings as a hero's journey. Adopting any of the strategic mindsets we've explored in this summary so far will go a long way toward future-proofing you and your company. But if you want to thrive in this ever-evolving new world, consider adding storyteller to your official title. Chapter 6 Strategic Mindset 6 Imperfectionism. No problem that landed on my desk, foreign or domestic, had a clean, 100% solution, said Barack Obama of his time as president. Instead, I was constantly dealing with probabilities. In the face of uncertainty and potential risk, doing nothing or betting the farm can often feel like the only options. But McLean and Conn argue there's a third possibility, their final strategic mindset, thinking like an imperfectionist. Imperfectionism is the overarching mindset that joins the others together. Imperfectionists recognize that they rarely have everything they'd like before needing to make a decision. But instead of letting the opportunity pass them by, or going all in and leaping before they look, imperfectionists display a rare tolerance for ambiguity and lean into risk with strategic intent. Acknowledging that risk can be risky, the authors offer two approaches for forging ahead. The first is playing offense, edging into the unknown with modest moves, moves that are low-cost and reversible but which equip you with the knowledge and experience to inform your overall strategy. Consider how Amazon entered the financial services arena. While their first two attempts could be viewed as failures, their later success with Amazon Pay wouldn't exist without either. Neither early experiment put the company in financial or reputational jeopardy, but both offered invaluable first-hand insight and helped build capabilities that eventually gave the company a 24% share of online payment transactions. If you prefer to play defense, look for ways to pass off risk to others better placed to handle it. A common example is how pharmaceutical organizations partner with universities and third-party biotech companies to develop and trial new drugs. Given that new pharmaceuticals frequently cost over $2 billion and take an average of 10.5 years to get approved, assuming they're even successful, it's no wonder these collaborations have become standard practice. Even industry behemoth Pfizer develops 77% of its products externally. It takes humility to admit that we don't know what we don't know, and it takes courage to wade into uncharted waters with the understanding that you might not win with a single bolt of lightning. Lean into risk with reversible moves. But the future has always been unknowable, it's just becoming harder and harder to pretend otherwise. So start practicing the imperfectionist mindset today. You'll save yourself a lot of whiplash later. Final summary: today's world is more ambiguous and uncertain than ever before. But amid all the chaos, one thing is clear: creative problem solving is the core strategic skill set required to thrive in these ever-changing times. Imperfectionist strategic problem solvers start with curiosity. They ask why. They then move to seeing things through multiple lenses or from multiple vantage points, typically anchoring these outside the company, in its ecosystem, or beyond. Next, they seek novel data on these perspectives via experimentation, augmenting this new data by crowdsourcing ideas and technologies to bring collective intelligence to bear. This leads to a pragmatic plan to step into uncertainty, gathering more information from small moves, while adding capabilities and assets, laying off risk to others where possible, and learning from mistakes and successes. Finally, they convince others to join in by telling compelling narratives of the road ahead. By adopting and developing the six strategic mindsets of curiosity, dragonfly eye perspective, experimentalism, collective intelligence, storytelling, and imperfectionism, you can gain the same critical advantage as the rare companies and individuals who are staying ahead of the curve. Thanks for listening. If you enjoyed this, please like and subscribe to the Literary Digest for more videos like this one. And don't forget to leave a comment below and let us know what you found most helpful. Until next time, keep striving for success.